now, wherefore if your hand or your foot offend you, cut them off and cast them from you. It is better for you to enter into life halt or maimed, rather than having two hands or two feet to be cast into everlasting fire. Mark, if your hand offends you, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than to have two hands to go into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched, where their worm dies not and fire is not quenched. If your foot offends you, cut it off. Okay, so Matthew combines hand and foot into one. Mark has them. I think what Mark has is probably more accurate, because Matthew, as we've seen earlier, he combines different sayings into one place. I think it would make sense for Matthew to combine the fact that he did say, if your hands offend you, cut it off. And then a moment later, if your foot offends you, cut it off. To just say, if your hand or foot offends you, cut them off. So I'm going to go the way Mark has it. Matthew, wherefore, if your hand. Mark just has, and if your hand. I think I'll put wherefore. Wherefore. If your hand. That's both. Matthew continues, or your foot offend you. I'll use offend you here. Mark just goes, offend you. So I'll save or your foot and go right into offend you. So still both offend you. Matthew reads, cut them off. Mark, cut it off. So I'll have cut and off. Cut, now Mark, it, both off. Matthew continues, and cast them from you. Mark has, it is better for you to enter into life maimed. Okay, so cast them from you is from Matthew only. And cast. Oh no. Matthew has them. But this statement's not in Mark, so I can't exchange it with anything else. Oh, I know what I'm gonna do. Okay. There's an it later on. It goes right into, it is better for you to enter into life halt or maimed. Mark has the same thing. It is better for you to enter into life. And I have to use it because Mark is speaking about just the hand right now, not hands and feet. So I'm gonna use the it from Mark. That would be more clear that I've moved a word over and I want it to be obvious. I know I'm explaining it now, but if you're just looking at the words and the colors, I want it to be real obvious. I'm moving the it there instead of them. So I'm gonna say it's from Mark. I'm not trying to hide anything. Cast it. And then from Matthew, from you. Now, it is better for you to enter into life. It is better for you to enter into life. But I already used it from Mark, so this it is only from Matthew. It. Now both is better for you to enter into life. Mark continues maimed. Matthew has halt or maimed. So Matthew first. Halt or. Now both maimed. Halt means lame. Maimed means crippled. Those words are actually rather old, so I will underline them and have the words explained in the notes. Rather than have two hands, Mark has then have two hands. So rather is Matthew only. There. Both than having two hands. Matthew continues, or 2 feet to be cast into everlasting fire. But again, because Mark doesn't have feet here, it just says two hands to go into hell. So I'm going to save or 2 feet. So it would just be in Matthew, to be cast into everlasting fire. Mark has to go into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched. So to go or to be cast. I think to be cast is better because once you know where you're going, you're not going to go willingly. So it's not just go, being forced to go. So two is both. Matthew only be cast. Matthew has into everlasting fire. Mark into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched. So I think I should have hell now and then everlasting fire from Matthew moved over to where Mark has fire that shall never be quenched. Because those are more closely related than just hell and everlasting fire. Into hell. Into the everlasting fire that never shall be quenched. Yeah. Mark continues, where their worm dies not and the fire is not quenched. That is repeated like 3 times here in this statement in Mark. It's not anywhere here in Matthew, though. But I'll put it, it is added. Where their worm is not, and the fire is not quenched.